As it currently stands, here in the United States, Muslims have to essentially hide their faith, or put up with really awful comments levied at them regularly, or they're given the evil eye, or are just generally treated with silent contempt.
Well, they shouldn't advertise it.
It's like telling gay people they shouldn't advertise being gay. I very much know what being told something like that feels like. And yes, I realize that being gay isn't something that you consciously choose. You don't choose who you're attracted to. But the faith that someone was indoctrinated with from their childhood wasn't something they chose either. They can get out of their faith, true, but I'm not going to hold it against them for not being able to get out of a belief system that they were indoctrinated with since they were children. I'm not going to be angry with or have fear of those people. I'm going to take pity on them more than anything. And they can be angry with me for declaring in this video that I am taking pity on them, if they want. And they can declare that their religion is what makes them strong. And I'll say right back to them that strongly believing in something with absolutely no evidence makes you gullible. And if it also goes against science, it makes you willfully ignorant. Abrahamic religion also makes you superstitious.
But you know, after all, if it's traditional and it sounds official, it must be the right thing, or something like that.
I am very thankful that here in the United States, Islam is not a popular nor a powerful religion. I'm very thankful it doesn't have any power. If it did, I'd be making a hell of a lot more of a stink about it like I do evangelical Christianity and dominionism. Some people try to claim that Islam isn't reforming at all, but I beg to differ. Just look at all of the Muslims that are in first world Western countries. The overwhelming majority of them are peaceful, they're integrated, and they're productive. When it comes to bigotry, statistics show that American Muslims are more accepting of LGBT than white evangelicals. But apparently it should be totally normal for Muslims to experience a lot of animosity from others if they dress in a way that shows their faith. Just as black people are somehow supposed to be all right with continually being looked at as criminals, unless they're really, really careful and obsessive about dressing in a way that looks completely the opposite of gangster. You know, it's almost as if they have to dress in pink Hello Kitty uniform, you know, in order to not have the police called on them for having a barbecue at a park.
Because after all, since Christian males don't experience those things, it's not important. And if you say that it's important, you have to make sure you gaslight the whiny little snowflake for a proper ponage. Remember, red coffee cups and happy holidays is what real persecution of Christians is all about. Trump and Fox News says so. And that's not supposed to be considered fake news, because right-wing Christian wholesomeness, family, just grab them by the pussy, I always say.